Good evening, everyone. On behalf of Bunker Hill Community College administration, faculty, and staff, it is my pleasure to welcome you to our honors and awards ceremony. I am Dr. James Caniff, Provost and Vice President of Academic and Student Affairs here at Bunker Hill. I wish to acknowledge our American Sign Language interpreters, Janet Bergstrom and Mark Riley. Thank you for your participation this evening. I am honored to be here this evening to celebrate the exemplary academic accomplishments of our student scholars. You should be proud, as we are, of what you have achieved at Bunker Hill Community College. On behalf of the college, I congratulate you on being recipients of these honors and awards. We thrive as an institution when we acknowledge and value the many strengths of our students. Scholars, you embody the energy, enthusiasm, intelligence, and compassion it takes to make a difference in our local and global communities. Tonight, we recognize you for all you have accomplished and for all that you will accomplish. And now it is my privilege to introduce tonight's presenters. I ask each of them to stand and remain standing so that we may acknowledge them as a group. Please hold your applause until they have been introduced. Dr. Pam Ettinger, President of Bunker Hill Community College. Clea Andriatis, Associate Provost, Charlestown Campus. Alice Murillo, Associate Provost, Chelsea Campus. Mary Ann Atkinson, Dean of Health Sciences. Lori Catalozzi, Dean of Humanities and Learning Communities. Leah Escalera, Dean of Behavioral and Social Sciences and Global Learning. Dr. Lori McCory, Dean of Science, Engineering, and Mathematics. Austin Gilland, Assistant Dean of Academic Affairs. Elizabeth Miller, Associate Professor and Chairperson of Computer Science, and tonight's faculty and staff speaker. And Josue Manrique Iguala Sanchez, a member of the Commonwealth Honors Program and tonight's student speaker. Give them a hand of applause. It is now my pleasure to introduce the president of Bunker Hill Community College. Please give her a warm welcome to the podium.
Good evening, everyone. It's always dangerous to follow Dr. Caniff. He's like a whole foot taller than I am. Let's see if we can get to the microphone here. So I hope that at some point, when we were waiting for the beginning of the program, I've gotten your photo. I think that's probably the best moment for me so far of today, is to see you with your family and friends around the table. So we're very happy to be able to gather and honor your achievements. You've put in the work, and tonight your hard work is recognized in front of your peers and your faculty and your staff and those who have helped you achieve. So on behalf of the college and the Board of Trustees, I would like to welcome everyone to this wonderful ceremony. This is a very special night for us, and I like to believe that we're really channeling Lin-Manuel Miranda in saying that, you know, for all of us who've come to this country, both recently and for me 45 years ago, immigrants, we really do get the job done. And I'm looking across to all of you and hope that you will bring that spirit of inclusion, that spirit of equity and diversity to everything that you do. And we hope that we have served you well while you've been here. So thank you very much for being here tonight.
Thank you, President Ettinger. And thank you for your hard work and your dedication to the students, faculty, and staff at Bunker Hill Community College. Now I would like to introduce the second of tonight's musical performances, performing Corner of the Sky from Pippin. Please welcome Bunker Hill Community College student Fred Isom, a tenor, accompanied by J.J. Tomchick on piano. Thank you, Fred and JJ, for that beautiful performance. We have such talented students here at Bunker Hill Community College. So happy to be here. Each year, during our honors and awards ceremony, we hear from a faculty or professional staff member nominated by colleagues to speak. This year's speaker is Elizabeth Miller, Associate Professor and chair of our computer science department. Liz has had a passion for all things science and technology since grade school. Her path began in oceanography, moved to programming, onto web design, app design, teaching both in elementary school and community college environments. She was an undergraduate and graduate member of the Scientific Research Honor Society, Sigma Psi. One of her proudest achievements at Bunker Hill Community College was the creation of the Honors Seminar on the Great Pacific Garbage Patch, which with Professor Andre Robinson, and introducing honors sections of core computer science courses. please join me in welcoming your faculty and staff speaker, Professor Elizabeth Miller.
We gather here this evening to honor all of you. I am in awe of the collective energy and hard work, star power in this room. I am awed by your dedication and your willingness to do hard work, to try new things, to put in extra effort, to risk your GPA, challenge yourself, to not take the easy path. Despite many obstacles, you have shown up, studied, learned new things about the world and about yourselves. You have participated fully as part of the Bunker Hill community. And tonight, we acknowledge and celebrate all of this with all of you. As a teacher, I'm proud to have had a number of you in my classes. And whether they have told you or not, your friends and families are proud of you and of your persistence, your dedication to your goals. But most importantly, I hope that you are proud. I hope that you are proud because getting here is not easy. Being here tonight is a huge deal. Own it. One of my favorite and often retold stories originated with the author Lauren Isley, and it goes something like this. While you're walking on a beach at low tide, you notice that the beach is covered with starfish, hundreds of them, caught on land and out of the life-giving water. Ahead, you spy a person picking up a single starfish and throwing it back in the water. Bend down, pick up, throw. Bend down, pick up, throw. Over and over and over again. And as you approach, you ask them, "What are you doing?" And the person answers, "Saving them." You reply, "But there's so many, it can't possibly make a difference." And the person turns mid-throw and tells you, "No, but it will make a difference to this one." You too make a difference. You are not only an example to others of dedication and persistence, but when you help someone puzzle a difficult math problem or philosophical conundrum, when you listen to a friend who is struggling, when you volunteer here at school or in your community, you make a difference. As you prepare to leave Bunker Hill to move on to transfer or careers, understand that your life will take unexpected turns, an unexpectedly difficult course that necessitates a change of major, the arrival or departure of a loved one, health issues for someone or for you, someone close to you, company shutdowns, family moves, any of these things can derail you for a bit, but know this, because you are here in this room, in this evening, you can overcome these obstacles and you can continue towards your goals. You have already proven that. Your future is bright, so go. Go out in the world and continue to do great things. And I thank you.
Thank you, Professor Miller, for your continued work and dedication to our students. This year, we are pleased to hear from one of our students who is being recognized this evening. This year's speaker is Jose Manrique Aguila Sanchez, one of the graduating Commonwealth Honors Scholars. Led by Professor Andre Robinson, the Commonwealth Honors Program supports students who are intellectually curious and enjoy the challenge of looking at things from new and different perspectives. When asked about Josue, Professor Robinson had the following to say. Josue has been an exceptional student ambassador for the Commonwealth Honors Program, helping raise its profile and status among students on campus. He has been particularly effective and introducing the program to international students and to his peers in the sciences and engineering. He represents the best of the program academically. He has been essential to the streamlining of program processes and has been an invaluable asset to the program. I think of him as the program's secret weapon. Please join me in welcoming our student speaker, Josue Manrique Aguila Sanchez.
That was a really nice introduction. I'm not going to say many words. 3 years ago, I walked through those doors of the B building for the first time. I was shy, insecure, and clueless. I didn't know what to expect, but I knew one thing. I knew I was going to work very hard for it. College can be a really stressful place. Hence, people's emphasis on socializing and engaging with one another. Community colleges are different. People don't come here to socialize. Well, we do sometimes. People come here to work hard, to make dreams a reality, to do what we can't, to imagine the possibilities. We community college students look for challenges. We look for complexity. We look for more. I discovered the honors program by chance, as though my destiny was to go across those doors in the program and be always attached to it. It felt warming. It might have been the impressive facilities, the secret location, or the beautiful beeping noise the door does when you put the code. But it wasn't that. It was their opportunity that caught me, and most of us. Being able to show our potential and much further. Though it wasn't going to be easy. Sometimes feeling like giving up. Sometimes thinking, this is not for me. We were not alone. We had each other. Great individuals almost total owners of knowledge. People whose dreams were as big as anyone and whose motivations weren't diminished by a 20-page paper due the next day. People at the program are hardcore. So we were. Although we are. We hustle. I would have never thought that being part of the honors program would have had such an impact in my life. I am thankful for meeting many people through this journey. People that I might have gotten into discussion with. Or people that I might have misunderstood sometimes. The honors program, as we like to call it, is ground for communication and learning. And yet, the Commonwealth Honors Program cannot be described in such a few words. The honors program is everyone here right now. It is all of you whose hustle, grit, and hard work have given the program the reputation it has today. Now, my fellow scholars, imagine the possibilities. Thank you.
Thank you, Josue, for your words, and congratulations on all of your achievements. You have a bright future ahead of you. At this time, we would like to extend special congratulations to those students, like Josue, are graduating as scholars of the Bunker Hill Community College Commonwealth Honors Program. The students graduating as scholars of the Commonwealth Honors Program will receive gold medallions in recognition of their impressive achievement in completing the very rigorous requirements of the Commonwealth Honors Program at Bunker Hill Community College. I ask President Ettinger to come forward for the presentation of the medallions, and Leah Escalera, Dean of Behavioral and Social Sciences and Global Learning, to the podium to announce the scholars.
Good evening and congratulations to all of our scholars. I am going to acknowledge all of our Commonwealth Honors Scholars, although some of them are not able to join us tonight. So first we have Karima Abolada, Josue Aguilar Sanchez, Maxime Adenau, Kira Borjas, Beverly Brewer, Joyce Bucare, Cecilia Caraballo, Cam Doe, Brandon D'Souza, Nicole DuPont. Elira Elshani, Stephanie Etienne, Romina Giassa, Ava Vanessa Gomes Montrond, Julian Hammond, Paulus Hayes, Carlina Alejandra Hernandez Correa, Musa Kamara, Yinghang Huang, Jesse Loudon, Raymond Oscar Lim, Nian Liu. Xiaolong Liu. Dainaba Andaye. Jennifer Oliveira. Isabella Oliveira Mahoney. Diana Perez. Chalissa Robinson. Lucas Samuel. Naima Tomi. Huang Tram. Laura Van Meel. Fatima Zahora. Karima Abolade. Congratulations to everyone.
Congratulations to all of the Honors Awards recipients. We will now present the 2019 Newmont Civic Fellowship Award. This award recognizes and supports community-committed students who are change makers and public problem solvers at campus compact member institutions. Fellows are nominated by their president or chancellor on the basis of their potential for public leadership. This year's award is presented to Dilrasbu Vuhidava. We are now reaching the part of the program for the departmental and academic awards, and I ask Associate Provost Andriadis and Murillo to join us on the podium, please. We will now present departmental awards in recognition of special achievement and academic excellence award in recognition of superior academic performance for each division. The department award goes to one student in each department for his or her outstanding accomplishments in the department's fields of study. The academic excellence award is given to the students with the highest grade point average in each department. All recipients are listed in the program booklet. We will be calling only the names of those students in attendance this evening. I will now ask Associate Provost Dr. Alice Murillo to introduce the deans in her area.
Good evening, scholars, faculty, staff, and guests. It is wonderful to be here tonight to celebrate our best and brightest students' achievements. Congratulations to all of tonight's award recipients. I now invite Marianne Atkinson, Dean of Health Sciences, to the podium to announce both the departmental awards and the Academic Excellence awards for her division.
Hello. The first award is for Thomas Finn in the Medical Radiography Program for a Departmental Special Achievement Award. Gata for academic excellence. She is also from the medical radiography program. Thank you.
I now invite Assistant Dean Austin Gilliland to announce both the departmental awards and the Academic Excellence Awards for the Professional Studies Division. Assistant Dean Gilliland is standing in for Michelle Elias Bloomer, Dean of Professional Studies, who was unable to join us this evening.
Good evening, everyone. First, receiving both the Academic Excellence Award and the Departmental Award in Business Administration, Jonathan Yuan. Okay. Next, receiving the Academic Excellence Award in It's ready for her award now. Receiving the Academic Excellence Award in Computer Information Systems, Mahesh Wosti. Receiving the Academic Excellence Award in Database Programming and Administration, Bao Jiamai. It's a long walk, Bao, sorry.
He'll also make a 150-yard split.
Absolutely. Receiving the Academic Excellence Award for Digital and Computer Forensics and Investigations, Fiona Lovett. Also receiving the Digital and Computer Forensics Investigations Award, Academic Excellence Award, and Departmental Award is Leonard Cantigliano. Receiving the Academic Excellence Award in Early Childhood Development is Leticia Angelo. Receiving the Academic Excellence Award in Gaming Computer Artist Track Simulation, Elizabeth Arezaga. Receiving the Academic Excellence Award in Information Technology Transfer, Ziaur Rahim Syed. Receiving both the Academic Excellence Award and the Departmental Award in Management, Joseph Connor. Receiving the Academic Excellence Award in Medical Information Management is Sumaya Bami. Receiving the Academic Excellence Award in Meeting and Event Planning is Rosanel Badio. Receiving both the Academic Excellence and the Departmental Award in Sport Management is Guarino Villar. Congratulations to the honorees from the Division of Professional Studies.
I now ask Dr. Lori McCory, Dean of Science, Engineering, and Mathematics, to come to the podium to announce the departmental awards and the Academic Excellence Awards for her division.
Good evening, everyone. I am delighted to announce the departmental awards and the Academic Excellence Awards for my division. Receiving both the Departmental Special Achievement Award and the Academic Excellence Award in Computer Science Transfer Option, Hakeem Benia. Receiving the Departmental Special Achievement Award in Computer Science Concentration, Felipe De Morales. Yeah. receiving both the departmental award and the academic excellence award in mathematics concentration, Alira Elshani. Receiving both the departmental award and the academic excellence award in chemical science concentration is Jessica Shilu Lee. Receiving the academic excellence award in computer science transfer option, Christopher Monraz. Receiving the departmental award in engineering transfer option is Isabella Oliveira Mahoney. Receiving the departmental award is Sonia Prey. Receiving the departmental award in biotechnology option, I'm so sorry, is Fatima Tu Zuhura. Finally, receiving
good girl.
And finally receiving departmental award in electrical engineering is Jericho Kenye. Congratulations.
I'd like to call back up Assistant Dean Austin Gilliland. We've missed a few names and we don't want to leave them out, so we're returning to the Professional Studies Division.
Sorry about that. I missed you guys. I needed to come back and say hello again. We have a couple of departmental awards that I missed on the first list. So a departmental award in criminal justice is awarded to Andy Rath. A departmental award in early childhood development goes to Jennifer Medeiros. A departmental award for education concentration goes to Isabel Fernandez. A departmental award in graphic art and visual communication goes to Nee Lee. A departmental award in network technology and administration goes to Paul Gargano. And an academic excellence award. Sorry, please feel free to applaud. An academic excellence award goes to Lynn Rodriguez in business administration taxation.
And we also have Dr. McCrory returning for additional awards in science, engineering, and math.
Not to be outdone, I too have one more. Please congratulate Cam Doe, who has earned the departmental award in mathematics concentration.
I believe there may have been a double awardee that only left with one of the frames. So if you are that person or persons, make sure you come back after the ceremony and pick up your second frame. Okay? Thank you.
Thank you. I would now like to introduce Associate Provost Clea Andriadis to introduce the deans and her divisions that she supervises.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome. We're incredibly excited to have you, the scholars, here with us tonight, alongside your family and friends, as well as our faculty and staff members from the college. We are all here in honor of your very special achievements, so congratulations. I now ask Dean Lori Catalozzi, who is Dean of the Humanities and Learning Communities Division, to come up to the podium to announce both the departmental awards and the academic excellence awards for her division.
Good evening. Receiving the departmental award in English, Avihai Shimon. Receiving the departmental award in general concentration, Karima Abuladi. Receiving the departmental award, as well as the academic excellence award for the liberal arts degree, Su Mei Ao. Receiving the departmental award, as well as the academic excellence award in music, Daniel Prietes Martinez. and finally receiving the Academic Excellence Award in the General Concentration Degree, Teresa D'Entremont. Thank you, Dean Catalozzi. I now ask Leah Escalera, Dean of Behavioral Social Sciences and Global Learning, to return to the podium to announce both the Departmental Awards and the Academic Excellence Awards for her division.
Hello again. I'm actually going to take you back to the beginning of the program to include one additional Commonwealth Honors Program awardee, Amanda Batista. Receiving the Academic Excellence Award for the Sociology Department, Catherine Hernandez. Receiving the Special Achievement Award for the Human Services Department, Musa Kamara. Receiving the Academic Excellence Award for the Human Services Department, Jennifer Moore. Receiving the Special Achievement Award for the Sociology Department, Jennifer Resto. Receiving the Special Achievement Award for the Psychology Department, Crisveli Soto Martinez. Receiving the Academic Excellence Award for the Human Services Department, Jose Torres.
Let me extend my congratulations to all of tonight's recipients. Before I close the program, I want to thank some people. One is our Director of Special Events, Kevin Weary, and his staff. He plans all of this room and how it looks tonight. Another one of our talented people here at Bunker Hill Community College. I also want to thank Karen Norton and the Integrated Marketing and Communication staff for their work, and also the Associate Dean of Academic Affairs in my office, Arlene Valley, who has really been So this concludes the presentation of our honors and awards ceremony. All recipients can pick up their certificates at the table where you checked in this evening. Now we have dinner for all of you, and we have a buffet at two locations, one here and one here. So enjoy the evening. Thank you for coming. Great to see all of you. Thank you.